Hello friends, in the last session we have seen a type of source which is called independent sources. Now why they were called independent sources was because the source quantity, it could be a voltage, it could be current, depending upon if it's a voltage source or current source, the source quantity is not affected by any activity in the remainder of the circuit. It means that if you have a voltage source of 6 volt, there is independent voltage source of 6 volt, it will remain 6 volt whatever else happens in the circuit. Whatever current is flowing through the circuit elements R1, R2 or anything like that, it will always remain that 6 volt. In this session, we are going to see a new class of sources which is called dependent sources, or they are also called controlled sources. Okay, so now there are two types here. One is voltage controlled sources, okay, and the other one is current controlled sources. Okay, so you are having voltage controlled sources and you are having current controlled sources. Now inside this you are having two other classification. One, it can be a voltage controlled voltage source, so voltage controlled voltage source, or a voltage controlled current source. Okay, and here you are having a current controlled voltage source, a current controlled voltage source, and a current controlled current source. So essentially what it means is that this voltage source here, the source quantity is dependent on a voltage in the circuit. Here the current source, the source quantity is current, so that current is dependent on a voltage of the some part of the circuit. Here you are having a voltage source, but however it is current controlled. It means that the value of this voltage source, that means the source quantity, is dependent on the current which is flowing in the remainder of the circuit. And here you are having a current source that depends upon the current which is flowing in the remainder, some part of the circuit. Let us see the representation of these four type of sources. So first you are having a voltage controlled voltage source, okay, then you are having a voltage controlled current source, then you are having a current controlled voltage source, and then you are having a current controlled current source. These are not very confusing terms, it's easy only, so there is nothing difficult about all these things. So you are having voltage controlled voltage source, VCVS, voltage controlled current source, current controlled voltage source, and you are having a current controlled current source. Okay, now to distinguish between independent sources and dependent sources, we put dependent sources inside a diamond box. So now it is a voltage dependent source, right? So this Vx is the voltage at some point of the circuit, and here also you can put a Vx because there you are having voltage dependence, here you are having Ix, and here you are having Ix. Now this is a voltage controlled voltage source, you can put K here, and this is a voltage controlled current source, so you have to put G here, and you have to have here R, and you can put here K. Now A, B, C and D. So in cases A and D, the K is having no unit. It is a unitless quantity. It is just a scaling factor. Okay, all these quantities are scaling factors, like K, G, R and K, again here, they are all scaling factors. But however, in A and D, K is unitless. Now in B, you need a current right here. This is actually a current source. Therefore, it will have a unit of amperes, right? I'll put it here like this. This is having a unit of volts. This is having a unit of amperes, and this is this is having a unit of volts, and this is having a unit of amperes. So in case B, G will have a unit of ampere per volt, okay. And in quantity C, because this is a voltage, and this should be volt per ampere. So why do you have these dependent sources? Actually, in modeling of electronic devices like transistors, you use these kind of dependent sources to model them mathematically. So that will come in the later section of the course. So with this, let us do a simple problem here with dependent sources. Now, in this question, the objective is finding VL. All right, the objective is finding VL here. Okay, and the given value V2 is 3 volts, and the sign is also given here. So plus minus V2, this is a voltage controlled voltage source. So the controlling voltage here is 5V2. Okay, so this is the scaling factor, and this was equivalent to that K in the theory, what we have seen in the last slide. So here let us analyze the circuit. By going through the circuit, you can clearly see the value of VL is nothing but the value of V2, okay, and V2 is given to be 3 volts. That means the value of VL is equal to 5 into 3, which is equal to 15 volts. Sorry, it is equal to 15 volts. So we have almost covered the voltage sources and independent voltage sources, and we have gone through the passive sign convention for power. With this, let us do one important problem in which we are going to use all these concepts together. So in this question, clearly you can see we have to find the power absorbed by each element here. We have to find the power absorbed by each element, and the circuit is given as such. So let us go through this one by one, and let us solve this problem so that we can have a good understanding on what we have learned till now. Okay, so let us take the first one. So let us take the power absorbed by the 7 ampere current source. So I will be drawing the current source here. So this is the current source. So you can clearly see it has a voltage marked like this, and the value is 7 amperes. So let us use the passive sign convention now. So power absorbed is equal to, you can clearly see that the current is leaving the positive terminal, right? The current here is leaving the positive terminal. Therefore, the power absorbed will have a negative sign. Okay, the power absorbed will have a negative sign. And what is the voltage? The voltage is given to be 8 volts multiplied by what is the current? It is 7, and that is equal to minus 56 volts. Okay. Let us take the second element here. The second element I want to take here is the second element. I will just mark it here. Let this be the first element. 1, 2, 3, 4, and let me mark this as 5 so that we get into some order. So I want to find the power absorbed by the second element. Okay, second element. So the second element has a voltage of 8 volts and given current direction is 2 amperes. So let us use the passive sign convention once again. So power absorbed here, you can clearly see this current has entered through the positive terminal. It has entered the positive terminal and it's leaving the negative terminal. So as passive sign convention says, you have to put a plus sign in front of the power. What is the voltage? 8 volts. And what is the current? 2 amperes. So plus 16 watts will be the power absorbed. Let us take the third element here. Let me put it 2, 3. So first element, second element. And this is the, yeah, this is the third element. Okay. So power absorbed by the third element. So let us put everything properly here. So minus plus 12 volts. Now here you might get confused, but there is no need for any confusion because we are having sign conventions to save us from any problem. Now the power absorbed here, okay? So now this is the sign which is given. So now you don't have to go around correcting anything here. So let it be negative, let it be positive, I don't bother, I have to only use my sign convention. So you can clearly see here the current is leaving the positive terminal, right? The current is entering here and it is leaving the positive terminal. Therefore, the power absorbed should be having a negative value. So minus, what is the voltage value here? Look at what is the voltage. It is 12 volts. You don't know what is Vx, so don't bother about that. It is given that it is 12 volts. So 12 into the current value is plus 5 amperes, so 5. So therefore, this is minus 60 watts. Okay. Now the fourth element, let us take the fourth element here. The fourth element is quite simple here. So plus minus 20 volt, and they have put 8 amperes here. So this is also 8 amperes. So power absorbed by the fourth element, as per sign convention, the current is entering the positive terminal, so you have to put a plus sign. So it is absorbing power. So 20 into 8, and that is equal to plus 16 watts. Okay, it is plus 16 watts. Now the fifth, let us see what is it. Yeah, the fifth one is interesting. It is given that it is a current source which is voltage controlled. So voltage controlled current source, and the value is given to be, the voltage across it is given to be plus 20 volt. So let us use passive sign convention here again. So you can clearly see that this 0.2 Vx is flowing here. It is going like this and it is coming here. So you have to put a plus sign, right? Plus sign. What is the voltage value? The voltage value here, the voltage value here is equal to 20 volts and the current is 0.25 Vx. Okay, so now the question comes, how you will find the value of Vx. So you can clearly see how you can find the value of Vx is that you can clearly see this is minus, this is plus, and they have given minus Vx. This is minus, this is Vx, and this is, they have given plus 12 volt. So clearly this minus Vx will be equal to plus 12 volts. That means Vx will be equal to minus 12 volts. Okay, so P absorbed in this case is equal to plus 20 into 0.25 into minus 12 volts. So what will that come up to? You will have a negative sign and it is minus 60 watts here. So with this, I would like to conclude this session, and in the next session, we will be starting giving a formal definition for networks and circuits, and we will be introducing Ohm's law, and we will be doing a lot of problems in all the concepts which we have consolidated till now. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll meet you in the next one. Thank you.